Okay, hi, Daiki. Today we are talking about Finnish and Estonian language, like how they are similar and how they are different. And I have a special guest here. She's Diana, Estonian. So she speaks English, Estonian, and Russian. Okay, so before we start, as a native Estonian person, how do you think about Finnish language? Because I'm sure you have heard of Finnish many times, so. And you can be honest.
I'm not gonna speak for every Estonian, but for me personally, Finnish sounds like drunk Estonian. I think there are some moments where I can understand Finnish, especially numbers and like some really like easy things.
Yeah.
There are some similarities, but when they speak about complicated topics, it just sounds very foreign to me. Mm. It's like they're. I don't know, it's weird. Like, I think drunk Estonian is the best way to describe it. I heard Finnish people say the same about Estonian.
Yeah, like, I've heard like some Finns saying Estonian sounds like drunk or Finnish.
Exactly, yeah, so it's kind of like, technically, they sound a little bit similar.
Okay.
You could sort of understand, but at the same time.
Okay.
Kind of weird.
But still, Estonian is the closest language to Finnish, I guess. They are like.
Yeah, they're in the same language group. So like Finno-Ugric languages, and technically Hungarian is in the same group.
Yeah.
But if you listen to Hungarian, it doesn't sound like anything like Finnish or Estonian.
Mm.
So in that sense, but if you ask like any foreigner, most of them whenever they hear Finnish or Estonian, they cannot distinguish them.
Mm-hmm.
For them, it sounds exactly the same.
Okay, so when you go to Helsinki, for example, and when you hear Finnish, you understand, I don't know, 10%, 20%.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, maybe. I can introduce myself in Finnish, and let's see if you understand.
Okay.
Okay, so just brief introduction. So, my name is Daiki. I'm a Japanese. I'm a Mutin Suomen Maisterin Tutkinta Varten vuonna 2016. Ja valmistumisen jälkeen mä aloitin työskentelemään Suomessa. Nyt mä asun Helsingissä.
Well, yeah, I think about 20% is correct.
Okay.
Like, there are some parts where my brain was just like, error.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
I think, yeah, mostly 2016, you went to Finland,
yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, you moved from one city to Helsinki. Your name is Daiki.
Yeah. Okay.
Basic things.
So, you're done. Yeah.
Okay. Tere. Minu nimi on Diana, ma olen 23-aastane, ma olen pärit Tallinnast, ma olen terve elu elanud Tallinnas ja ma lõpetasin nüüd sellel aastal kõrgkooli, õppisin aegs. Ja nüüd ma asusin tööle.
Okay, I think I understood first 30%.
Okay.
So your name.
Okay.
And you are from Tallinn.
Mm-hmm.
Your age is 23.
Mm-hmm.
And then no.
And then no.
Yeah.
It's kind of similar. Like when I was working in a hotel, the same thing happened with Finnish guests. It's like you can understand the very simple things, but once they start actually talking with each other, what? Yeah.
Okay.
I think so.
Yeah. So I was checking some like how Estonians are similar.
Mm-hmm.
If we have like same words, similar words, and according to some website, for example, numbers are almost same. Like 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay, so it's not really similar, but I think the spell is a bit different.
Yeah, because Finnish put like at least the first like 10 numbers, I guess they put I at the end.
Yes,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ah, 5, okay.
Neljä, yeah.
Yeah.
Father, isä.
Isä.
But in Estonian it's isä.
Mm-hmm.
Like ISA. Because in Finnish it's
How do they say like daddy in Estonian in Finnish?
Isi.
Isi. Yeah, Isi. Same as.
Okay. Okay. Nainen, Finnish.
Yeah, nainen.
Nainen, like meaning woman. God, Jumala, in
Jumal.
Finnish, Jumal.
Mm.
So no A.
Mm. Interesting.
Yeah.
But of course, my favorite one is hallitus.
Hallitus.
Because in Estonian it means mold.
Hallitus in Finnish means government or cabinet.
Mm.
And?
In Estonian it's mold.
Mold.
What is viineri?
Viineri?
Danish pastry. Because in Estonian.
Viineri. Danish pastry.
Because in Estonian viiner means like sausage.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
And also. Ah, okay, this one.
Koristama.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Koristama ruumi means in Estonian to clean the room, but in Finnish it means to decorate the corpse. Yes.
So in Estonian, ruumi is room.
Room,
in Finnish, ruumi is body. Okay.
Muru means like...
It's like darling, dear, my
really?
Sweetie.
Really?
Muru.
In Estonian, muru is grass.
Grass, like green grass.
Yeah.
Okay, because I know some parents think muru to their kids.
Muru is grass in Estonian. Okay. I think I would laugh if I did that. Actually, the first word that I said, tura, you know, the one that means, you know, that hernia.
Yeah.
In Estonian, it's a curse word.
Really?
Tura is like a male genital, basically.
Ah,
it's used as a curse word.
Okay.
So that's why it's a bit funny.
Okay, so let's see how much you understand this easy Finnish.
Mm-hmm.
It's about weather forecast.
Sää on sunnuntaina melko pilvinen. Monilla alueilla tulee sateita. Maan länsiosassa ja Pohjois-Lapissa on poutaa, eli ei sada. Lämpötila on 12 ja 18 asteen välillä.
I think it highly depends on the topic. Yeah, because this one I was just like, what is going on?
Okay, sää on sunnuntaina melko pilvinen.
No, pilvinen is like cloudy.
Cloudy, okay.
Yeah, this one I can understand, but like...
Mostly.
If he speaks about like northwest, all that kind of stuff. I'm
so it's different.
Yeah, because in Estonian we say põhi, lõuna, ida, lääs.
Ida is same.
Yeah,
east.
Ida.
Länsi.
Länsi, läns.
Läns. Pohjoinen.
Põhja. And
etelä.
Lõuna.
Okay.
Etel we say, I think it's one of those that goes to the...
Ah, okay. Okay.
And also we have, in Estonian we have ü, which...
Ü. What's ü?
It's, you know, you have, in Finnish you have an O with two dots on it. We have that, and we also have an O with like a roof on it.
What?
Yeah. So you say ü.
Ü.
No. Ü.
Ü.
Yeah. It's a little bit like, you know, if ü is a bit like,
yeah.
You're feeling sick.
Yeah.
Ü is like ü.
Ah.
Ü.
So sick or like you are kind of like
you
find
like,
it something disgusting.
Kind of surprised in a disgusting way, like ü. What is that? Ü.
Okay.
So we say like udne, for example, which is scary or bad. Oh god. Uppilane. Yeah, uppilane.
Uppilane. Meaning?
Student.
A student?
Yeah. Opettaja.
Opettaja. Ah, opettaja.
Opettaja.
Opettaja. Sounds like opettaja, teacher.
Yeah,
right?
Teacher, yeah.
Do you have U plus two dots?
Yes. We have all of the same letters as Finnish does. Except
no, but we don't, like, Finnish doesn't have U plus two dots.
Ah, yeah, so you use the Y instead of that,
yeah.
Right? Like, in Estonian we have the U plus two dots.
Two dots.
Ah, I have an Estonian tongue twister that has,
okay.
I think it has U in it, I'm not too sure. Let me try. Anna, ulu, ule, ulo,
ela. Okay.
So, Anna, repeat.
Anna,
ulu,
ulu,
ule,
ule,
ulo,
ule,
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 ula.
Ule.
Anna ulu ule ulo uela. Give me, like, pass me the beer from Ulo's sister's shoulder.
Ah, okay.
But it's like whenever you say this to anyone who doesn't speak, like, okay, even to Finnish, I think this sounds really
weird. It sounds like you are drunk or something.
Yeah, but if you speak it to foreigners who don't know, like, any Estonian or Finnish, then it just sounds like a joke. It's like you're just like, oh, like this.
Have you heard of this Finnish tongue twister?
Koko, 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 koko. Correct?
No? Yeah. Gather up a full bonfire. A full bonfire? A full bonfire. Okay, so it's like a three-show sentence.
For me, this sounds like, you know, like when if there's like this bird walking around, like koko, koko,
koko. True.
Kind of like that, yeah.
Yeah, anyway, most Finnish and Estonian languages are. Cool.
Similar but different.
Similar different. Kiitos. It's Aida.
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 Aida. Aida.